A YouTuber sued for cyber libel by former Philippine Senator Kiko Pangilinan. The Liberal Party chairman also filed a complaint against officers of YouTube Philippines and Google. Pangilinan said malicious and libelous content of Bungangera TV depict him as a person who abuses his wife and children. He included YouTube and Google as respondents for failing to act on his complaints. In a statement released Monday, YouTube said it has an online legal removals web form where people can submit complaints against content they believe violates their rights. It points out local legal considerations are taken into account when evaluating these requests. Well, former Senator and Liberal Party Chairman Francis Kiko Pangilinan now joins us here on the program. Senator, good afternoon. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Hi, magandang hapon and maraming salamat for having me, Carlina.
All right.
And,
so,
noon to everyone.
Yeah, so about this cyber complaint that you filed, you know, when you look at it, when you're at the receiving end, there's a point wherein you think you want to be the bigger person. I'm not going to pay attention to it. Things will just resolve itself. But how did it go from disgusting to criminal? What's the trigger, Senator?
Well, we repeatedly appealed to YouTube to have it taken down. Mula pa nung December ito eh. March na. No? So, walang action. And million na ang nakakapanood ng video. And talagang kabastusan at pambababoy no, ang laman nito. And surprisingly, well, not surprisingly, but disappointingly in a sense, kung kailan lang kami nag-file kahapon ng umaga, pagdating ng an hour or 2 hours later, tinanggal na ng YouTube yung channel. No? They took it down. So why do we have to go through a million views of garbage and of you know, libelous, really crazy, bizarre, absurd material before they take it down? I don't want to sue anyone in particular. I don't want to, you know, go up against these social media giants, but they're leaving me with no choice. And I'm thankful that when a lot of people have sent me messages of support saying it's about time, because this is too much, you know, this is horribly too much, and it is no longer, it is completely and totally unacceptable, and we have to fight back.
We tried to look for the account responsible for all these content, and you can't see it, you can't access it. Do you know if YouTube was actually the one who took it down, or did the owner delete the channel herself or himself?
Well, that's a good question. No? But the last time we filed the case, which was about 2 years ago, it was YouTube who took it down. So we are still trying to determine. That's why there's so much, napaka, ang laki nung kawalan ng transparency sa mga proseso, sa social media, sa mga media, social media giants. We don't know. They lord it over, they make decisions, and we're all kept in the dark. And that's why even this is a breeding ground precisely. Dahil sa anonymity, dahil sa kawalan ng transparency, naglalakas ang loob ng kusino-sino. Yung channel na kinasuhan natin, walang pangalan, walang mukha, no? Pero milyon ang nagpapanood. Siyempre, panawagan din natin sa ating mga kababayan, huwag basta-basta nagsishare o nagsasubscribe o kaya naniniwala sa kasinungalingan. And one more thing, and this is also an appeal, Carmina, to the business community and the advertising agencies, please stop putting money on your ads on these channels that are propagating disinformation, lies, and falsehoods. We are all enabling them. In fact, we are looking at the possibility of also filing, if these ads are still in this other, marami pang iba. Yes. If there are ads in these other channels that are producing all this kabastusan, we are also exploring filing civil cases of damages against the companies that have place their ads there because kumbaga moral damages dahil pinopondohan nila eh. Ilalagyan nila ng pinagkakakitaan yung kasinungalingan.
Which brings
so I hope that the business community, the advertising agencies, we come together and help each other get rid of these YouTube channels. Even Sharon, by the way, I was just speaking to her earlier, nag-usap lang kami. She is also preparing charges against another YouTube channel and another personality precisely because of the lies and all these attacks on our children, my family. Tama. Ang ayaw naming magsampa ng reklamo pero sobra na. No? Anak ko na, mga anak ko na, my wife, my children, our family, we are all being subjected to this really absurd, horribly, how do you call it, scurrilous, talagang pambabastos na hindi na tama, hindi tama.
Well, Senator, let's get into that because to a user, right, you see a clickbait, you click on it, you get entertained for a while, you think you know that what you're watching is the truth, but to the family, to you in particular, the recipient of all these, you know, eyeballs on your family for the wrong reasons, right? How has it been? When was it when you first came to know of the first post, of the first defamatory post by the channel, and what happened after that, and the feeling, and what your family had to go through? Go ahead.
You know, well, I have been subjected to trolling for the last 7-8 years since 2016. Na walang patin. So when you ask me when, paulit-ulit na, no? Yung kabastusan, yung pambababoy, yung pag-atake. But this recent case was just last December. Pero there was another case precisely of attacking my family, my wife, my marriage a couple of years ago. Pero ganun talaga. Itong mga, sabihin na nating walang mabuting gawain. Sabi ko nga, hindi pa sila, buhay pa sila pero yung kaluluwa nila ay isinusunog na sa impyerno dahil pinagkakakitaan itong pagsisinungaling, pambababoy ng kapwa, at paninira. So yes, it's not easy for us, but this is one way of telling the public, you know, because of course, may mga maniniwala, di ba? May mga alam mo naman ng mga iba nating mga kababayan, mabilis mabilis magmaniwala. Hindi naman lahat. Pero yung mga naniniwala, kinakailangan ang mensahe sa kanila. Kaya tayo nagsasampa ng kaso na ito dahil kasinungalingan itong mga ginagawa at sinasabi sa social media na dapat labanan.
Pero,
and this is also for all others who have been subjected to so much hate, so much anger, so much attacks on their persons on social media. It's about time that the Department of Justice comes up with, and hopefully the courts as well, would come up with legal parameters within which, you know, these social media giants and how we are to address this information. Of course, legislation too. We, in the last Congress, we had a Senate committee report on disinformation when I was chairman of the Constitutional Amendments and Revision of Codes Committee. We had a number of recommendations there, one of which was the registration of the SIM cards. So, but there are several others. But it cannot work unless the private sector, the business community, of course, the Department of Justice, the academe come together with civil society and citizens come together to fight disinformation. Grabe ito.
Yeah, but Senator, balikan lang natin yung sinabi niyo kanina. You're dealing with faceless, nameless entities here. Right? Nung nagsampa po kayo ng kaso, paano kaya ang magiging proseso dito? Dahil hindi nyo alam kung sinong nasa likod, hindi ba? Paano mangyayari dito?
Well, ang request natin doon sa ating complaint is for the NBI Cybersecurity Division to compel, you know, YouTube and Google to preserve these materials. We do have them on file because we have been monitoring them. We will, in fact, we have them as attachments. So merong ano yan, merong footprint yan online na maaring ma-secure, no? Yung URL and even the telcos have to cooperate because every YouTube channel requires cell phone registration. So hopefully we all come together to get behind these people. Hindi dapat simple lang na i-take down. Mm-hmm. Dahil pag nag-take down ng isang account, magbubukas lang ng isang account.
Mm-hmm.
Di ba?
Mm-hmm.
So, kumbaga, it does not address the serious issue of disinformation and the criminal activity.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And also, if I may appeal, the larger picture here is that how do we address, you know, these criminal activities, these illegal activities on social media. Someone has said, a former Facebook employee said that Facebook is actually a crime scene because you have not just criminal libel, not just civil liability of damages, you know, against persons who are being subjected to all these lies and attacks. You have child pornography, you have women trafficking of women and children,
yeah.
All happening on the net. No? So it's about time too that we all come together and address the challenges of how to regulate social media. Mm-hmm. And in my case, this disinformation and the criminal libel.
Let's go back to that criminal libel complaint that you filed against those behind Bongangera TV. You had several choices here. Do nothing, let it resolve itself. File civil damages, which is, I understand, as you said a while ago, your wife, megastar Sharon Cunata, is going to do so in a few days. And then you have the filing of cyber libel. Now, why choose the third one, considering the discourse surrounding it, to decriminalize libel? That has been the fight. And yet here you are filing cyber libel against those behind Bongangera TV. What was the thought process there, Senator?
Well, that's the law that we have today. You know, obviously, if it was decriminalized, I have, you know, then we will not file a criminal case. We will still file a civil case for damages. No? But that is the law, law as it is today. And therefore, we will use this particular law to go after them. And I think, you know, it is justified in a sense that at this point, you know, there is no accountability whatsoever. There is impunity, and even. Even the social media giants are not acting, unfortunately, as responsibly, in my, you know, and as quickly. So that's precisely why we filed this case. We were left with no choice at this time. But hopefully, in fact, I said this, nabanggit ko na ito, ayoko namang ikulong itong mga taga-Google. Wala naman akong gustong makulong dito kahit na yung mga nasa likod niyan, pero ayusin lang, di ba? Ayusin lang nila. Yun lang naman ang gusto natin dito.
You know what the other side is probably going to say, Senator? They're probably going to say, you know, this tramples upon free speech. What do you say to that? They're using free speech to do whatever it is to do more harm. What do you say to that?
You know, you have the right to free speech, but you don't have the right to spread disinformation. You know, we have the right to this to information, but you don't have the right to spread this information. So that's what I will say to them.
And what do you think this cyber complaint, the damages that will be filed, or the charges that will be filed in the coming days as well? What message do you want the public to get from this?
That we should not. Na hindi dapat katanggap-tanggap yung current situation na yung paninira, yung pambababoy, pambabastos, lalo ng pamilya, lalo na yung mga anak natin, ay hinahayaan natin. Darating ang panahon na malilinis din itong mga basura dyan sa social media, pero hindi mangyayari yan kung tayo ay nananahimik, kung tayo ay nagwawalang tibok. No? Sabi nga nila, ang karapatan ay hindi karapatan hanggat hindi ito ipinaglalaban. So yun ang ginagawa natin dito. And this is not just for me, not just for my family, although of course it is primarily for my family dahil private sector na ako ngayon. Wala na nga akong wala na akong kinalaman sa gobyerno ngayon, di ba? Pero ganun pa rin. No? So this is also for all those who have been subjected to abuses. I would say this is verbal abuse on social media na kinakailangang mapigil at mapigil.
Former Senator Francis Kiko Pangilinan there joining us this noon. Thanks again for taking our Zoom call. Take care.
Thank you very much. And Sharon says hello, Carmina.
And please say hello back.
Thank you.